everyone, I hope you guys are doing great and welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be showing you how to make this pufferfish pouch. The pattern for this pouch is pretty simple. We will use half double crochet as the base stitches to make the body. And to make it look more like pufferfish, it has some little spikes around its body that I made it out of triple crochet. So we're gonna mix the half double crochet and triple crochet to make the body. And here is the pouch part. You can put any small essentials inside of it. Then when you pull the strap tightly, it will have this cute kissy face. So let's start crocheting. For this project, I'm using 5-ply mil cotton yarn, a 4mm hook, a scissors, a tapestry needle, and a pair of safety eyes. We will start with the body. Make a slip knot or a magic ring. Next, chain 2. We will continue do 6 half double crochet in the very first chain. So yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, and then grab the yarn, pull out the loop. Now we have 3 loops on our hook, and then yarn over and pull out all these 3 loops. And this is our first half double crochet. Now we will continue to make 5 more half double crochet. After that, slip stitch in the first half double crochet, chain 1, and we will continue to the next round. So start from round 2, we will start making the spikes and also changing the color. We will use triple crochet to make the spikes, and you can make it in any stitches you want. So you just have to change the half double crochet with triple crochet for the spikes. For round 2, we will do a half double crochet increase, repeat for 6 times. For the second stitch, I will change the half double crochet with 1 triple crochet but still in the same stitch. So this is our first spike and also it still counts as an increase. That's why we will have 12 stitches for this round. Next, continue to the third stitch. We will change the color. So we will work with this blue yarn for 5 stitches. After that, at the 5th stitch, we will change the color to the main color. Then we will continue crocheting with this main color until the end of the round. Next, slip stitch in the first stitch. Chain 1 and we will continue to the third round. For the third round, we will do 1 half double crochet and then 1 increase, repeat for 6 times. In the end, we will have 18 half double crochet or 18 stitches. Now at the 5th stitch, we will change the color. We will work with this blue yarn for 8 stitches. Remember, when you grab the blue yarn, make sure that it loose like this so it's not too tight because it will be easier for you to work with this blue yarn. And make sure that you also keep crocheting this main color with you so it will be hide under your stitches. Now I will continue crocheting with this blue yarn until I have 8 stitches. After we have 8 stitches, we will change the color and we will continue work with this main color until the end of the round. This is how the inside looks like. It looks so neat because we hide both of the main color yarn and also the blue yarn under the stitches. Now I will continue repeating this pattern and we will meet at the end of the round. Next, slip stitch in the first stitch, chain 1, and we will continue to round 4. Next, for round 4, we will do 2 half double crochet and then 1 increase, repeat 4 6 times. In the end, we will have 24 half double crochet or 24 stitches. Then at the 5th stitch, change the color. We will work with this blue yarn for 12 stitches. I will continue crocheting with this blue yarn and we will meet after I have 12 stitches. After having 12 stitches, we will change to the main color and continue work with this color until the end of the round. I will continue repeating this pattern and we will meet at the end of the round. After that, slip stitch in the first stitch, chain 1, and we will continue to round 5. For round 5, we will do 3 half double crochet and then 1 increase, repeat for 6 times. In the end, we will have 30 half double crochet or 30 stitches. Then at the 7th stitch, we will change the color. We will work with this blue yarn for 14 stitches. I will continue repeating this pattern and we will meet after I finish all the 14 stitches. Now we're at the 14th stitch. Then we will change the color to the main color and continue work with this main color until the end of the round. I will repeat this pattern and we will meet at the end of the round. Now slip stitch to the first stitch, chain 1 and continue to round 6. So start from round 6 to round 9, we will not do increase anymore, so we just have to crochet around. Then we will have 30 stitches in each round. Then at the 7th stitch, we will change the color. We will work with this blue yarn for 15 stitches. I will repeat this pattern and we will meet after I finish all the 15 stitches. Now we're at the 15th stitch, we will change the color to the main color and continue work until the end of the round. So all we have to do now is just repeating the same pattern and we will meet at the end of round 9. Now we have finished until round 9 and this is how it looks like. Next, we will continue to round 10, chain 1, and we will do 3 single crochet and then 1 decrease, repeat for 6 times. In the end, we will have 24 single crochet. For the decrease, we will do the invisible decrease, so we will work in front loop only. Insert the hook into the first front loop and then go to the next one. Next, yarn over, pull out the 2 loops, and then we will finish it off just like a regular single crochet. So this is how we do the invisible fasten off. Now we will continue repeating the pattern. Next, we will change the color and working with the blue yarn all along the blue row. I will repeat this pattern and we will meet at the end of the blue row. We are at the end of the blue row. Now we will change the color to the main color and we will work with this main color until the end of the round. We have finished round 10 and this is how it looks like. Next, we will start making the mouth, change the color. I will use dark blue and count this attachment as 1 chain. So, for round 11, we will start with 2 single crochet. Chain 2. Skip 1 stitch and go to the next one. We will do 2 single crochet. So we will repeat this pattern around. 2 single crochet, chain 2, and then skip 1 stitch. I will repeat this pattern and we will meet at the end of the round. Now this is our last chain 2. Skip 1 stitch and slip stitch to the first single crochet. Now continue to round 12, chain 1, then we will do single crochet around. For the chain 2 space, we will only do 1 single crochet. So in the end, we will have 24 single crochet. I will continue crocheting and we will meet at the end of the round. So we have done with the body. Next, finish it off, chain 1, cut off the yarn, and fasten off. So this is how pufferfish body looks like. Now we will continue to make the fins. For the fins, we will do it at the round 8. Then grab the last stitch with the main color before we change to the blue yarn. Next, attach the yarn. Then chain 2. Continue do 5 double crochet in the same stitch. Next, chain 2 and slip stitch in the same stitch. After that, finish it off with chain 1, cut off the yarn, and fasten off. So this is our first fin and we have to make another one in the other side. Now we will make the tail, start with a slip knot. Then chain 7. After that, start from the second chain of the hook, we will do 1 double crochet, 2 half double crochet, two single crochet, then slip stitch in the last chain. So this is our first row, now chain 1, turn our work and we will continue to the second row. Start from the second row, we will work in back loop only, so this is the back loop. Now do slip stitch, 2 single crochet, two half double crochet, and one double crochet. So this is our second row. Now chain 1, turn our work and we will continue to the third row. For the third row, we will also work in back loop only. So start with one double crochet. Two half double crochet, two single crochet, and slip stitch. Next, finish it off, chain 1, cut off the yarn, and leave a long tail for sewing. Now we're making the eyes, start with a slip knot or a magic ring. Then chain 2, continue do 8 single crochet in the very first chain. Next, finish it off with the invisible fasten off. So, cut off the yarn, leave a long tail for sewing. Pull out the tail and grab the tapestry needle. Then skip the first single crochet and insert the needle into the second one. Don't pull too tight. Next, go back to the back loop of the stitch where the tail comes out of. So this is how we do the invisible fasten off, and this is how it looks like after I attach the safety eye on it. Now we have to make another one. Next we will do the strap, start with a slip knot. Then chain 55 or as long as you need. After that, cut off the yarn and fasten off. So this is our first strap and we have to make another one. Now it's time to assemble all these parts together and we will start by sewing the tail. So we will sew it at the bottom of the fish and make sure that it's in the middle. Now we will sew it back and forth and we will meet after I finish sewing. Now we have done with the tail and we will continue to attach the strap because it will make us easier to attach the eyes. We will start from the behind and we will attach it back and forth. Now continue to the second strap. We will attach it in the other side and start from the hole that is even to the first strap. Then attach it back and forth just like we did to the first strap. Now we will make the tail shorter and secure the straps by making a knot. Next, we will find out where to attach the eyes, so we will pull tight the strap and then look at from the top of the body. Now place the eyes near the mouth. So this is where we attach the eyes. I will continue attaching the eyes by sewing it, but you can also use glue to attach it. That's all for today's tutorial. I hope you guys enjoy this video, and please don't forget to hit the thumbs up and subscribe buttons. I can see that around 85% of you who is watching this video right now aren't my subscribers. So your subscribe really means a lot to me, and it will really help to keep this channel growing. Also, feel free to tag me on my social media if you make this project. Thanks for watching and have a lovely day, everyone.